Dr. Beckingham here again. This is part two of my thyroid series. I'm glad you're joining me here. If you have any questions, you can contact me at www.westlathyroiddoctor.com. Email me at drbeckingham@gmail.com. Call me, 310-614-2024. Today, I'd like to talk about finding answers for thyroid problems. It all starts with lab tests. That's the building block we're going to start with, okay? Have you been told that your lab tests are normal, but your symptoms are still there? What's going on there? You still feel bad, but you go and your doctor says, oh, your lab tests are normal. It's all in your head. I'm sorry to tell you, it's all in your head. Or maybe, oh, your lab test is off a little bit. Let's take your synthroid from 0.05 to 0.75. That's what we're going to do. We're going to up you up 50% and see how you feel. It's kind of like a guessing game. That's no good. So lab ranges. Traditional lab ranges are set back years and years ago. What I look at is something called functional ranges, all right? Functional ranges are a little more accurate. So let's be clear here. A lab range could be, let's say, on a scale of 1 to 10. If you are 9.5, you still would be lab normal. But technically, you'd be very close to abnormal. The functional ranges are closer to the middle. See, traditional lab ranges use a bell curve, okay? Functional values are much more sensitive to what we're looking for. So I'll show you an example here. Lab ranges go from here to here. If you're here, you're technically lab normal, right? The functional range is right here in the middle, though. This is important. It's where I want my patients to be when they come with their lab tests. If you're right here, you're functionally abnormal. You've got symptoms. You're sick. Your hair's falling out. You're constipated. You can't sleep. You're getting agitated. You got brain fog. Where did I put my keys? I get that with the brain fog one all the time. Functional range is right here in the middle, okay? These have to be normal for me to say you're normal. You have to be here. If you're here, it's abnormal, and there's something wrong with you. So functional range is what I look at in all my testing. So that's the reason why your lab test could be normal, and you still have symptoms, because you're in here, and the lab says you're normal, but you're not functionally normal. Here's an example. We use blood sugar, glucose. This is an easy one. Traditional sick lab range, 65 to 110. If you're in there, you're normal. Hey, I got blood sugar 70. Oh, good. That's good, right? What if your blood sugar is, 82? You'd be in between 65 and 110. But in reality, for my functional ranges that I use in my clinics, I want you between 85 and 100 for blood sugar. So 82, you'd be hypoglycemic, low blood sugar, getting weak before you eat. You get irritable before you eat. You know you have to eat or you're going to take someone's head off, right? Let's talk about TSH. Traditional sick lab ranges is 0.3 to 5.7. If you're a 4.2, they say, oh, you're fine, your TSH is fine. In reality, I want you between 1.8 and 3.0. If you're 4.2, you're hypothyroid. There it is. That's how you can have numbers so close. But if you're 0.4, okay, you might be hyperthyroid. We don't know. We need to have you right here, though, in these functional ranges. Same with cholesterol, triglycerides, hemoglobin. For anything that you can get on a blood test, I want functional ranges. And I put them right through my functional blood chemistry analysis software in my office. And it spits it all out, and we go over it together when we sit down. Typical thyroid test order. This is the 1960s model. What they would do is TSH. All right, you got TSH done, maybe you got T4 done, and that's about it. I want to see much more than that, okay? If this is all that's been done, this is almost negligent what's been done to you. We have to look further, we have to look deeper, okay? I want to see T4, T3, free T4, free T3, TGV, TPO, reverse T3, T3 uptake. I mean, there's so many, they're all pieces of the puzzle that I need to see. If you have a puzzle and I only give you two pieces, what is it? But if you have 10 pieces of a 10-piece puzzle, now we can get the picture, right? So now your treatment would be based on limited information if you only had two tests. That's why you have to go get more testing. So people come to me, I tell them to bring the test, we go over them and say, hey, I don't know what's going on until we get more pieces of your puzzle.